that can destroy a lot of people. That can not be stuffing out their kids and what have you. But the most important thing was, how did I react? And I thought, right, I'm going to prove him wrong. So I remained at Coventry for 4 years. The manager changed. My final year, a guy called Bobby Gould came in. Didn't go on. So a year later, I was still about 20 years of age, I get not kicked out, I get let go. On a scrap heap, you could say. Now, people always say, what's the hardest thing as a manager? Because I was playing manager at Barnes as well. What's the hardest thing? And they always say the hardest thing is letting young players go. Well, I walked into that manager's office that day. The previous evening, I played for reserves. We won 7-2 against Middlesbrough, and I'd scored a few goals. So the next day, I went into the manager's office, and they looked at me and said, well, what do you think is going to happen to you? Knowing full well, he's letting me go. And I just said, okay, sir, sir, whatever's going to be is going to be. This is what I'm letting you go, with a smirk in his face. And I thought, right, okay. Took his hand, got out. For me, that can destroy a lot of people. That can not be stuffing out their kids and what have you. But the most important thing was, how did I react? And I thought, right, I'm going to prove him wrong. I am going to prove him wrong. 20 years of age, not got a job, on a scrap heap. I could have went back to Scotland, several Scottish clubs wanted me. But Bradford City came in for me at the age of 20. And it was Terry Yorath, he was assistant manager who had been at Coventry. I'd played with him at Coventry. So him and Trevor Cherry brought me here to Bradford City as a young 20-year-old. On a scrap heap, point to prove, but boy, I loved it here. I absolutely loved it here. And those, I could drop down from top flight to the third tier of English football. But I went somewhere where I was wanted. I got away from Bobby Gould, who made my life hell, and I went somewhere where I was wanted. And over the next 4 years, I played 173 consecutive league games. So 4 years. And a lot of times you're going out, you're only half fit because you've got little knocks and injuries, what have you. But I carried on. You don't get many players playing with knocks and what have you. Sometimes I wouldn't train all week, just training on late Friday morning and go out, maybe like 70% fit, but still get through it. So the first game I missed was in the fourth season, the playoff game at the end of the season. That was the first game I missed, and that was because I was suspended and sent off for kicking the goalkeeper. So, as I say, I dropped down two divisions, but that first season, Bradford City won the third division title. We were sort of young lads with two or three old heads in the team. Well, we used about, over the course of the season, maybe 14 players all season. So that shows you how close the number are. And at the end of that season, obviously, we were celebrating promotion. We'd won the third division title, and it was the last game of the season here. And we were, for some reason, up to this day, I don't know, we were giving our medals before the game. Given the trophy before the game. To this year, I don't know why. We'd done a lap of honour before the game, and on the pitch, thank you fans, big banners and what have you. And then tragedy struck. There was a fire here. Worst day of my life. There was about 56 people killed in that fire. Boys and girls, I mean, I remember just
it was terrible.
Absolutely terrible. It was an old wooden stand, and someone dropped tobacco underneath it. An old man putting his pipe out, and obviously the tobacco's all stuck, moulded together, going underneath paper like that. And we were about 43 minutes into the game, so we thought, what's going on here? We didn't know what it was. We thought it was just hooliganism and what have you. It was a fight. So we ran back to the dressing room. Most people tried to run out through the top turnstiles. I know it did never get back up. It was like little kids talking to one another and what have you. And it was just, it was terrible. I mean, we came back into the dressing room and within minutes. So, well, within minutes, someone said, get out, there's a fire, and we to run out through the office and get the top, yeah. And it was just out into the street, and it was just mayhem in the street. Mums and dads, grandparents, children all shout for one another because no one knew where the loved ones were. So it's quite a sad day, as I say, the worst day of my life, but you've got to tell the story about the history of that and what have you. And we had 56 people lost their lives. We had to move ground. We couldn't play here because obviously the fire, so we had to play at Leeds United, we played at Huddersfield Town, and we played at the rugby stadium. We had to do that for what, 18 months. We didn't have a home. So, but we all grouped together. We sort of went to, paid a lot of hospital visits, went to a lot of funerals, and all the fans with bad burns always said, listen, come on, just get a car and play for us. So, this is why for me, in Bradford City, special for me. So, come the end of 4 years, guys, I moved. Obviously, as I said, I missed the last game of the season in playoffs. That was the first game I'd missed in 4 years. And we lost the playoffs to Middlesbrough. If we'd have won the playoffs, we'd have been in the top flight. So when I left Bradford, we just missed out the playoffs to get into the top flight.
What year was this?
88. Oh. 1988. So I came here in 84, the third division. And I left in 88, we just missed out the playoffs into the top flight. So I moved to Newcastle. I moved to Newcastle United. Top flight club, big club. So I moved up there, they came in and bought me, I think it was 500 grand or something, paid for me. A year later, Newcastle were in trouble with, they were getting taken over. They were getting taken over with boardroom, struggle and what have you. And I was the only sale of a last set, so I got sold for 600 grand to Leeds United. Then at Leeds United, helped him get promotion into the top flight. But that summer, Middlesbrough came in for me. So I made my way back on the road to Middlesbrough. So in the space of two years, at four clubs, 88, I've gone from Bradford to Newcastle, 89, Newcastle to Leeds, 1990, Leeds to Borough, where I stayed six and a half years up there. Club captain, player of the year there. Done well, had good times, 6.5 years in Teesside, good memories, played with a lot of fantastic players, played top flight football. Then the Premier League, came into England. I scored the third ever hat-trick in the English Premier League. Third ever hat-trick. We beat Blackburn Rovers 3-2. It was against my boyhood hero, Kenan Dalglish. I was a Celtic fan as a boy. He was a Blackburn manager and I scored the hat-trick. First Scotsman to score a hat-trick in the Premier League. So, that was good. Yeah, six. So, I mean, basically, at the age of what, 32, 33, I moved to Barnsley. I left Borough, who at the time, in October 96, I think they were 8th in the Premier League, and I moved to Barnsley, Championship. In that season, I won Player of the Year at Barnsley. Barnsley got promotion into the Premier League and Borough came down. And Borough had all the superstars like Juninho, Ravenelli, all these guys. And they got to two cup finals that season. But I'd got to Barnsley and I helped Barnsley achieve promotion into the top flight. And it's the only time Barnsley have been in the Premier League in 130 years history. As I said, he Player of the Year, scored about 17 goals that season for him. And had a good year. So, all in all, I was probably an apprentice 1 year, a pro 18 years. I was fortunate to do that in England. As I say, I was Player of the Year at Barnsley, Bradford, Borough, what have you. Scored the last goal at Goodison Park before they moved to the new ground and what have you. So, lots of happy memories. And Barnsley went into the Premier League, playing against all the big clubs, Man United and everything else. We knocked Man United out of the FA Cup. We knocked him at the FA Cup and I scored in both games. I scored at Old Trafford. Fans were over there, it was just full house, and it's the best feeling in the world. It is. And I remember my dad coming down from Scotland, my mum and dad and my father were there, and I remember just going up to Trafford, and it was just like a tears in my eyes. It was just like saying, wow, I felt a bit 12 foot tall again, and, you know, just running back. So, got Man United back to Barnsley, and we beat them 3-2. Beckham and all those guys, Beckham, Giggs, all those guys, knocked them out of the FA Cup. A year later, Man United won the treble. They won the Champions League, they won the FA Cup, they won the Premier League. The season before, little Barnsley, that knocked him at the FA Cup, and that was great memories. So, all in all, as I say, I started as a winger, then at the end of my career I became a striker, more like a central striker as such. Barnsley, we get relegated, then I became manager. I was playing manager at Barnsley, and I was playing manager when we were in the Championship as such. Obviously, you only seen that a wee while, and that was when I finished at Barnsley, that was me retired, and here I am now, guys. Here I am right now. So, from a wee boy at the age of 16, leaving Glasgow to come down and play a bit in the game for 19 years professionally, it was something that I'm proud of, but something that I worked hard for, and people don't realise the amount of sacrifices you had to make. I mean, I had to leave my family behind, home to Scotland. Rarely see them, and what have you. So, to make a living out of the game, I made my sacrifices. I worked ever so hard. There's the old saying, you only get out what you put in, if you're prepared, put hard work in. And that's everything in life, not just your football, your academics as well. You're all failing to prepare to fail. Those things are all going on, the signs and the dressing rooms and what have you. So, all in all, I'm proud of what I achieved, and I had a really good career, and I loved the game. Mm-hmm. Loved the game.